Welcome to the BPA platform training videos from Codeless Platforms. Here are the objectives, required tools, and approximate running time for this video. On completion of this exercise, we will see how to extract the status of orders from a database, upload them into an HTML report, and send the report in an email on a scheduled basis. This will be broken down into several short videos that cover the objectives listed in the accompanying documentation. This video will cover parts 1 and 2. To begin, we will create a connection to the training database that can be used by any task. This is referred to as a global connection. Let's launch BPA Platform, and from the Task Manager, go to BPA Platform, System, Tools, Data Connectors, and double-click Database Query, ODBC. In the dialog box, click Add. Expand ODBC Drivers, and select SQL Server. Then click OK. Choose the relevant machine name and associated database instance from the server dropdown. We now need to supply our credentials. Click Options, choose BPA Platform Training DB from the database dropdown. Leave all other settings with their default values and click OK. Type a meaningful name for this ODBC data source, then click OK. The new connection appears in the ODBC Connections window. Use Test to ensure a working connection. The first step of the task is to extract the order details from the BPA Platform training database. We will use the Database Query ODBC tool for this. From the Task Manager, right-click on Tasks and select New Task. Let's name the task Scheduled Order Status Reports. Add a description, order status report emailed on a daily basis, and now go to the Design tab. Okay, let's right-click in the Design area and select New, Data Connectors, Database Query, ODBC. We will add a name for this step, DBQ Recent Orders. From the Connection dropdown, choose the Database Query connection we created, and then go to the Query tab. From here, we will specify the columns that contain the data we are interested in order to extract the data we want in the report. Expand the following tables and drag the specified columns into the Columns pane. The tables are automatically added to the Tables and Joins pane as you go. However, you must manually join them. From the Tables and Joins pane, highlight Order Number in the SOP Item table. Drag it onto Order Number in the Sales Order table. Let's do the same for Account Ref in the Sales Order table to Account Ref in the Sales Ledger table. Okay, we will now narrow down the extracted data by ignoring those orders that have already been dispatched. Drag Dispatch Status Code from the Columns pane to the Criteria pane. From the Select a Criteria dropdown, choose Equals, type 0 in the box provided. We can further narrow down the extracted data by only requesting those non-dispatched items that have an order number. That is, those that have been successfully processed into the database. Drag Order Number from the Columns pane to the Criteria pane. From the Select a Criteria dropdown, choose Is Not Null. Finally, we're going to sort the data alphabetically according to the order number. From the toolbar, click Sorting to add a sorting pane to the design view. Drag Order Number from the Columns pane to the Sorting pane. Your query should now look like this. To ensure the query works as intended, click Execute. You should see these records returned in the Results tab. And now click OK to save the database query step. And that's it for this video. We have created the connection to the database and extracted the data. In the next video, we will create the report template and set up the send email step. Thanks for watching.